everyone. So I would like to start by making a bold statement that the topic for the day is motivation, and the bold statement would be that I cannot motivate anyone in this room. Neither I, nobody in this world can motivate anybody until and unless you try to motivate yourself. So I would like to start with a story of a boy, and with this story I would like to inspire yourself, to motivate yourself to achieve whatever you want to achieve in life. So this boy was born in a middle class family. Father was a civil electrical engineer. Mother was a housewife. Studied in a convent school till class 9th, then joined the Air Force school. So when he was entering into his teenage, his father, before that his father was working with an organization, then he got into starting his own company. So that was the time, like, he was called as a businessman. So we didn't have entrepreneurs at that time, like 25 years back from now. So that little boy, when he was in school, so his friends used to tell that, okay yaar, now that ab tere father ki company hai, to hume bhi apni father ki company mein job de dena. So that kida of starting something of your own entered into the head of that boy. Then things were going well, but unfortunately his father got diagnosed with diabetes, and because of diabetes his kidney got failed, and unfortunately that boy lost his father when he was in class 12. But that was the time when a person, an individual, requires something like a father in his life, because that is the time when you are entering from your school to your college. That is a transition when you are making. That is the time when you need someone like your father most, because you can discuss a lot of things. But that was the time when that boy lost his father. But that boy took control of his life. He had things in mind, that he had the clear idea that after 12th he wanted to do something in computers. So after completing his class 12th, he got the admission in NIIT, did a course, a DNIIT, diploma in software engineering from NIIT. Then got an opportunity to work with NIIT. The boy got 98% in the first semester. So the people, the instructor and the directors of the institute asked him to, if you would be interested in taking up a job as a trainer. So that boy discussed about this opportunity with his mom. So his mom told that, see, your first priority is your studies. If you think you are capable of doing both the things together, so you are free to take that opportunity. So he took that opportunity, worked with NIIT for 3 years. Then he got an opportunity to know about call center. So this all was happening in Jamnagar. So Jamnagar, so being in metro city, we come across things quite early, but being in Jamnagar, the call center thing was new. So he thought of knowing about the call center thing. So he got an opportunity to attend the seminar. Then after attending the seminar, they asked that if anybody is interested in taking up the job, so they can come to Gandhinagar and they can give the interview. So that boy went with his friends, and he was the only one who got selected for that opportunity. So he started his career with the international call center in Gandhinagar. Then due to some health challenges of his sister, he had to again move back to Delhi. He started his career with Airtel here in Delhi. Then one day while he was working with Airtel, so he realized that this is not something that I wanted to do for the whole of my life. So that kida of starting up something of my own got struck, and he decided to start a call center training institute. So then again there was this dilemma that where we should start. So he took an emotional decision and went back to Jamnagar and started that call center institute. But things didn't went well, so he had to close that after 2 years and came back to Delhi. Then changed his business model. Instead of setting up a center here in Delhi, he collaborated with the trainers, created a database and started doing projects. Things went well. And in 2014, he decided that, okay, he had been into training. So he made a transition from speaking to, from training to speaking. And that is how the speaking career for that boy started. He started writing a blog. In 2014, he started with a blog. And that blog went well. In less than 6 months, the visibility of that blog was in 102 countries. And today, that boy is working like is on a platform of Speakin. And one thing I came to know about Speakin, that my association with Speakin was even before Speakin got into existence. It was something like Indian Speaker Bureau or something of that sort was created before. So I was part of that also. So that I came to know like recently. So the story I was telling about the boy, that boy is me. So I think the time constrained it there. So I think whatever I have told you, I have made you inspired to do something. Like one thing which I want to tell you, that curiosity is the key. If you want to keep yourself motivated, so curiosity is the key. Keep yourself, develop that habit of curiosity to keep exploring new things. So whatever I have done till now in my life, I give a lot of credit to the curiosity in me, because if you are curious, you will always be ready to learn new things. And when you are learning, you are always growing. So by this, I would like to end my talk. Thank you.